In this video lesson, let us continue to understand more about the effect of acidic strength by the electron withdrawing group attached to the carboxylic acid. Electron withdrawing groups, examples, some of them are members of halogens. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, members of halogens. And nitro group, cyano group, they are all the examples for electron withdrawing group. Whenever such electron withdrawing groups are linked with the carboxylic acid, naturally the acidic strength of the carboxylic acid increases due to negative inductive effect or maybe due to resonance effect, or sometimes both of them will be having their own effect on them. So now let us see with an example. Here I have taken up the comparison between ethanoic acid and chloroethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid and chloroethanoic acid. Which of them will be a strong acid now? Now here you see that ethanoic acid is having the presence of a methyl group, which is actually electron donating in nature. And chloroethanoic acid is having an chloro group, which is actually electron withdrawing in nature. So therefore, if the carboxylic acid is attached to electron withdrawing group, it will help in increasing the stability of the carboxylate ion by taking away the electron or helping in dispersing the negative charge on the carboxylate anion, thereby increasing the stability. Therefore, chloroethanoic acid will be a fairly strong acid than ethanoic acid. That means ethanoic acid is less acidic than chloroethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is weakly acidic than chloroethanoic acid. So with this, what is a conclusion we can draw? We can say that if an electron withdrawing group like the members of halogen or nitro or cyano group are attached to the carboxylic acid, they help in maintaining the stability of the carboxylate ion, thereby increasing its acidic strength. Now, if this is one case, let us see what will be the acidic strength if more than one electron withdrawing group is present. Now I have taken up the example of this compound. What is this compound called? Trichloroethanoic acid. If you watch the previous video about the acidic strength, you will be able to understand why am I calling this as trichloroethanoic acid. Then we have this compound, namely dichloroethanoic acid. What is the formula of dichloroethanoic acid? CHCl2. You see 2Cl there, so therefore it is dichloro, otherwise it is 2-carbon compound with saturated carbon and it is carboxylic acid. So therefore the name would be dichloroethanoic acid. And I am also considering this acid, namely chloroethanoic acid. So, what is the common thing that you observe in all of these three examples I have considered? Yes, you are right. you are able to see the presence of chlorine in all of them. Now, chlorine, as I already told you, is an electron withdrawing group. Apart from this, what else do you observe? You observe that in trichloroethanoic acid, there is 3 electron withdrawing group. Because each chlorine is an electron withdrawing group, therefore 3 electron withdrawing groups are present in trichloroethanoic acid. Here, 2 electron withdrawing groups are present in dichloroethanoic acid. Similarly, only 1 electron withdrawing group is present in chloroethanoic acid. So now, how will be the acidic strength of these acids? Please remember this point, dear students. Higher the number of electron withdrawing group attached to the carboxylic acid it is attachment I am talking about, not withdrawing. So I am returning, I am writing the arrow facing the other side. Higher the number of electron withdrawing group attached to the carboxylic acid, what will be its acidic strength? Greater will be its acidic strength. Acidic strength will be greater. I repeat, higher the number of electron withdrawing group linked to the carboxylic acid, greater will be its acidic strength. So when we apply this here, what do we observe now? Trichloroethanoic acid will be greatly acidic than dichloroethanoic acid. It will be greatly acidic than ethanoic acid. So the second point you should remember in electron withdrawing group is that higher the number of electron withdrawing group linked attached to the carboxylic acid, greater will be its acidic strength. Parallelly, you should also remember another point about the distance of the carboxylic acid. Closer the distance between the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid, greater will be the acidic strength. Farther the distance of the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid, greater will be its acidic strength. So if it is nearby, the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid are close by, then greater will be its acidic strength. If the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid is far apart, then weaker will be its acidic strength. Let us try naming these compounds. What do we see? 1, 2, 3 carbon atom, and for the third carbon atom there is a linkage with Cl. So therefore this compound is called as 3-chloro-3-chloro-propanoic acid. 3-chloro-propanoic acid. 3 carbon atoms saturated, so propane, E of the propane should be replaced by OIC acid. So therefore 3-chloro-propanoic acid. And similarly, what do we see here? 1, 2, 3, and for the second carbon atom it is linked with chlorine. So this is called 2-chloro-propanoic acid. acid. 2-chloropropanoic acid. Because of the shortage of space, I am writing it one below the other as next lines. Dear students, when you write, make it a point that you write it in the same line itself. Okay. So now what is that you observe? Between this and this. Here, if you observe in 3-chloropropanoic acid, the chlorine is attached, or the chloro group, the halogen, is attached to the third carbon atom. Now here we observe it is closer by. So therefore, the ability of electron withdrawing for this chlorine is more than for this chlorine. So therefore, the distance also is to be accounted. So closer the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid, greater will be its acidic strength. Similarly, farther the electron withdrawing group and carboxylic acid, weaker will be its acidic strength. So of the two, which is going to be the acid which will be having greater acidic strength? Obviously, 2-chloropropanoic acid. So if I were to write the relationship between them, what is that I am supposed to be writing? 3-chloropropanoic acid is weakly acidic or less acidic than 2-chloropropanoic acid. This is purely based on the distance. So like this, 3 points regarding electron withdrawing group has to be remembered. I will go through quick repetition. First one, if a halogen is present attached or any electron withdrawing group like halogen, nitro, cyano, etc. if they are present attached to the carboxylic acid, their acidic strength will be greater than that which does not have the presence of the electron withdrawing group. For the reason, the carboxylate ion will be stabilized more by the electron withdrawing group by helping in dispersing the negative charge on the oxygen of the carboxylate ion. Now here this one, higher the number of electron withdrawing group present linked to the carboxylic acid, greater will be its acidic strength. Then point number 3, the distance between the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid decides its acidic strength. Lesser the distance between the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid, greater will be the acidic strength. Far apart the electron withdrawing group and the carboxylic acid present, weaker will be its acidic strength, because weaker will be the ability of the electron withdrawing group to draw the electron from the negative charge of the carboxylate ion. Okay, so like this, the effect of substituents on the acidic strength, if the substituent is electron withdrawing group, will play a vital role.